special, no special video or downloads. Straight up the title theme. Episode 5, Cry Wolf.
You've come a long way. You must be tired.
Yeah, about to sit down, smoke. Oh, I need to have a seat.
And if my envoys are correct, you haven't had a lot of rest recently.
Please,
Sheriff, relax for a moment, will you? Do you want a drink? Something to eat? Vivian makes a very nice, very... It's elegant. Really, a carpaccio. It's lobster. Sirloin.
I'm here for one reason, and it's not to eat your fucking food.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you think you're doing?
He's gonna...
Mr. Wolf is our guest, and I have every intention of cooperating. So don't waste the silver. Sit down, Jersey. Well, Sheriff, for the sake of transparency, why don't you tell us why you're here? It would help settle everyone's nerves, I think.
You're destroying this town. You've been doing it for ages.
Destroying this town? What on earth do you mean?
What the hell do you think I mean? Slavery? Kidnapping? Extortion? Murder? What would you call the wholesale corruption of Fable Town?
I would call it the baseless accusation of a desperate sheriff. How are you certain this isn't some conspiracy against me? I'm a well-connected man. Well-moneyed. People do like to take their shots at me.
You're right that there's a conspiracy. But you're the one behind it.
I have no need for treachery, Bigby. I do everything right out in the open. But I can understand the confusion, and I'm truly sorry about the trouble all this has caused you. And I hope you believe me when I say, Sheriff, that I sincerely mean to make it up to you. The recent murders that have gotten such attention as of late, I don't relish telling you that they were perpetrated by an employee of mine. It's a very unfortunate bit of business, but I promise you that the matter will be dealt with internally. I just want to settle the issue for you and to assure you that it's over with.
An unfortunate bit of business? You're gonna tell me right now who killed him?
Sheriff, I have complete respect for you and your job. I hope you know that. But I simply can't divulge that information. You really shouldn't worry yourself. As I said, I've got this under control.
No, I'm gonna deal with it right now.
Yeah, right. What do you think this is? Some kind of negotiation? The man said he'd take care of it. So why don't you take the hint and get out?
I'm already pissed off. You don't want to make it worse.
Oh, I think I do. I'd love a good reason to put a bullet between your eyes. After what you did!
That's enough!
You'll be alright.
I was hoping it wouldn't come to this, but in the interest of preserving our alliance, if you have to know, it was Georgie.
Wait, for what? Killing people?
However, like I said, I'd be handling the matter if you don't mind.
Georgie?
You got what you wanted, so just...
Sit down. Now.
Yeah, I killed him, so what? You should have just kept your nose where it fucking belonged.
You piece of shit. I should have fucking known.
He's the one. I guess it is.
George here misinterpreted one of my instructions.
Misinterpreted?
And I want to make things right. So, let's work something out.
What's there to work out? I'm protected, aren't I?
Your protection has limits, and I think you've far exceeded yours. That you could murder someone in cold blood like that.
You fucking asked me to do this.
And then attempt to blame me for it. You will be silent while we discuss what to do with you.
This is right bollocks, sis. You're just gonna let him do this?
He's gonna attack me.
So what do you say, Sheriff? Can we discuss terms? You can have Georgie. Consider it a gift. Ensuring our continued cooperation.
All right, let's talk.
You can't just hand me over! What the fuck is this shit? You said you'd cover for us!
For minor infractions, not murder.
Just go with him, Georgie. You're gonna sink us all.
What's wrong with you people? You're really gonna sell him out just like
you
that?
You think I give a fuck if I'm the one... Who the shit do you think you fuckers are?
Get the fuck out of here!
I do apologize, Sheriff, but I think it's best if you leave now.
There's no way I'm going with him! Are you kidding me?
Things are about to get unpleasant, and I would rather you weren't here to watch.
You can go join that whore at the bottom of the lake for all I give a shit, but he's not taking me anywhere. I'll roll over on the lot of you before I let that shit happen.
What are you saying?
I'm grabbing this.
Get the fuck away from me! He's the one you fucking want!
This could have gone
but
so well.
You're the one killing people.
But you just had to complicate things. To speak the truth, I've never been a very good mediator. Why negotiate when you can just decide?
Oh, nah. What the fuck? Okay. Well, that's creepy.
Did I miss anything good?
Oh, she about to take the gun out and shoot.
Well, look at you all fixed up.
God damn.
Over here.
Shit.
You're done, Wolf.
Come on, we're pretty much done here.
I'd like to say it was nice knowing you.
Oh, goddamn. If I mess up, I'll probably die. Dude, that'd be scary as shit if you just run right in.
What was that?
Thank God I was right. God, he's coming to turn around.
Gun it!
Are you sure?
Do it!
He's not moving.
Keep going!
George's blood.
Holy shit.
He got stabbed. This house of straw.
Come on. We can't stay here.
Hang on. I need a minute.
Okay. How did this happen? Can you stand up? It's okay. Take your time.
But I'm walking in.
It's no fucking use. No way I'm walking out of here. Well, it won't be your fault.
He's losing a lot of blood. He's about to die anyways.
Shit. Hello, Bigby. I hoped you'd come to your senses. Crooked Man's the one you want. But of course, you're too much of an idiot to see that. Or maybe you just like me too much to let me go.
I'm taking you in, Georgie. Let's go.
You gonna carry me?
Please, no. Sheriff. Haven't you done enough? Look at him. He's dying.
Vivian,
get out of the way. Now.
No. It isn't his fault.
He's a murderer. Faith and Lily, he's the reason they're dead.
Look, I know he made a few mistakes. We all have.
What?
He made sure they couldn't talk with those damn ribbons, and then he killed them. You're wearing one yourself. Doesn't that bother you even a little, knowing that man murdered—
Of course it does. Those girls—
So it's all my fucking fault, then.
You're the one killing them.
You're gonna throw me to the fucking wolf, too? You know I didn't have a goddamn choice. What the fuck? I did what I had to! You can't fucking blame me for that.
You didn't have to do anything.
Like hell I didn't. Look, Faith and the others tried to pull a run on us. And as you can imagine, the Crooked Man wasn't too thrilled. But of course, the big boss didn't want to get his fucking hands dirty. So he told me to take care of it. You think I don't know what that means? Either I do what he says or I'm the one getting dealt with.
Yep.
So I fucking killed him. And I'd do it again. Because it's not my fault. The Crooked Man gave the order. He told me to kill them. And then he fucking sold me out.
That's not my problem.
Oh, I get it. When a pretty little girl shows up at your door wanting help, you've got all the time in the world. Yeah. But when I've got something to say, it's not your problem.
Seems like everyone else.
Well, fuck you. Go ahead and arrest
me,
but it won't bring back Lily or Faith. It won't free your friend Narissa. And I'm just the sap taking the fall for the whole thing. It must be so easy being you. Just come in here and blame me for all this shit. Job's done, right? George is the bad guy. It's all his fucking fault. But what was I supposed to do? You don't know what it's like, Bigby. How could you know?
Stop complaining and take responsibility for what you did. You murdered Faith and Lily. You put those fucking ribbons around their necks. You had the power to let them go, but you chose not to.
You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. If I freed them, what would you have me do? Kill her?
Georgie, don't.
It was them or Vivian. So you tell me, if freeing Lily meant she had to die, you still think I had a fucking choice?
Wait, how is she involved in all this?
This is the original.
Oh, okay.
The girl with the ribbon. I'm sure you've heard the stories. Couldn't take it off, Couldn't talk about it. She used her little purple ribbon to make more of them. To keep our girls quiet. To ensure absolute discretion.
You promised you wouldn't.
All that magic is connected to this little thing. You remove hers, and the spell's broken. They're all free. But you know what happens to her? The same thing that happened to Faith.
Dead.
So don't you come in here and tell me I fucked up.
What the hell, Georgie? We were supposed to look out for each other. I trusted you.
How could you do this? I thought you cared about them.
I do. Of course I do. You have to understand. Nobody was supposed to die. When we built this place, it was just a stupid idea. A gimmick. Discretion is our guarantee. That's how it started anyway. This was supposed to be our place. We were going to be in charge for once, and nobody would try to control us or use us. That was the point. And the Crooked Man showed up, and everything just turned to shit.
So, do you get it now? Why I couldn't just... If you still think it's so fucking simple, then you do it. Go right ahead. Kill her, then.
What are you doing?
Break the spell! Save the fucking day!
I'm not playing this game, Georgie. I won't kill her.
Don't talk about me like I'm not even here. Please. You think this is hard for you? My life is such a fucking burden on your conscience. Don't I get a say? It's my life. Like it was either of yours to give up in the first place.
I wasn't really-
You're right. It's your life.
I know what I've done.
Wait!
I'm sick of everyone thinking that they can just do what they want with my life. I thought it would be different here, but it's all the fucking same.
Vivian, I didn't mean-
Do you think I wanted to be this person? What I did to Faith and Lily, to all of them.
Vivian, wait,
Every day I have to look Gwen and Hans in the eye and pretend I don't care. I have to forget what I've done to them, what I took away from them. I look at Nerissa, and I hate myself.
Vivian!
I can't pretend anymore.
What are you doing?
Vivian!
Uh-oh.
Don't!
Goodbye,
Vivian!
Georgie.
No!
Oh...
Fuck! No!
Damn.
Why'd you have to do that, Vivian?
God damn.
Vivian!
Are you happy now? Is this what you wanted?
No.
Vivian, I didn't fucking mean it. I was just...
Oh, damn. So everyone else is free then, alright? And she's just dead.
Oh, fuck!
Get up.
Get up! Don't think so, Bigby.
God damn.
I'm gonna die here. I think we both know that. Just make sure you give the Crooked Man the same treatment when you find him. Really fuck him up for me, all right?
He's gonna have it worse. Don't worry.
Actually, no, I don't kill him.
Good.
I wanna keep him.
Old foundry by the river, all right? Shepherd Metalworks. He'll be there. Fucking asshole. You wanna finish me off now?
No.
Or do you plan to kick me around a little first? Rip my limbs off one by one? That's what you wanna do, right?
That's not who I am.
Sure it's not. No more games, all right. We both know how this ends. Just make it quick. I know what I did.
Just leave him. I'm gonna leave him. He'll slowly
what?
Die.
You're just gonna leave me here?
Yeah.
You'll have plenty of time to think about what you've done.
Fuck you!
Leave
piece
your ass
of
alone.
Shit.
I got a book of fables. Shepherd Metal Works. Alright, we're here. Why couldn't you use the car? Couldn't I just take the car and drive it? I would probably hide the keys or something.
So this is where they've been sending these.
Oh.
Bigby Wolf. The Big Bad Wolf. You used to be something.
Is that Faith? Oh, that's everybody. That's all the people. Yeah. Yeah, Faith. Snow. Three random girls. Okay.
They used to fear you.
Shush.
They'd hide anywhere their small shivering bodies would fit.
Is that the same whale? Oh my gosh. Oh, workbench. Oh, this is silver bullets.
Silver.
Yep. Damn.
It's about time you showed up.
Alright, so when I talk to
her, I had to take care of some things first.
Gotta pick,
little
hey,
errand
I'm talking
boy.
To you.
That's nice.
Ah, Bigby. I see you made it here in one piece. I do apologize, but I have some business to attend to. I leave you in the capable hands of my associate. Come find
okay,
me when you're
so,
finished, dear.
Don't
this,
worry.
This part right here.
This won't take long.
Get out of my way now.
You got to fight her
this
for
this worse.
Aw, he doesn't want to play.
I'm sure you'll persuade him.
Yeah, I'm talking.
Hey,
here you go.
I'm talking to
see,
you.
Press circle for that.
Didn't your mother ever teach you manners?
Oh?
Or was she too busy fucking whatever breeze drifted through town?
Oh? Damn. I want to knock her ass out. Fuck that bitch.
Oh, come on. Is that the best you can do?
Come on, Big Bean, there's supposed to be no action, and you can come in here beating up people. Probably have blood all over you again. Alright, so that's it for the book. That was the only thing you needed for the Book of Fables. I think everything else should be fine. I don't think she's there, but... Oh my gosh! That was fast as shit.
Oh,
so fast.
Where are you? Come out and face me!
Oh, shit. Okay, Silent Hill creature, like shit. Self-destruct? Pretty much.
Hello, Bigby.
I thought he left.
You look tired.
Give me one good reason not to rip you apart right now.
This gun holds...
No.
I won't miss next time.
Don't care about
the gun. Before you do anything with me, I thought I should point out a few things. Snow White wants you to bring me back to the woodlands, doesn't she? And that's what I want.
That's right. But what happens to you once you get there is a different story.
I'm not quite finished. You will bring me back alive.
Yeah.
Look, all I ask for is a chance to speak for myself in front of the community.
At least I got Georgie, so that's good enough.
And I'm sure Miss White
that's revenge
would agree
enough.
That I should be given a fair trial. Can we at least agree on that? I will have a trial.
The whole town will be calling for your execution. Why would you want me to bring you back there?
Why don't you let me worry about that?
No.
Look, there's no reason for us to be at each other's throats here.
That's funny, coming from a guy pointing a gun at my head.
This is just a precaution. I'm sure you understand. I'm no murderer, Mr. Wolf. I didn't kill those women.
Chaos.
And
there
I
you
think
are.
You know that. All I'm asking for is a chance to explain my side of the story.
Bullshit! I already talked to Georgie. I know you ordered their deaths.
Mr. Porgy is mistaken, I assure you. I'm a businessman, not a killer.
There's still a lot
but
you have
both.
To answer for.
And I will, as long as you agree to my terms. Because I'm not saying another word until I'm brought before the community. I don't mean to belabor the point, but just so we're clear, if you change your mind and decide to do something stupid, you won't get your answers. But you will have a difficult time explaining yourself to Miss White and the rest of this miserable town. You're often reckless, and I worry you're not thinking of the... Let me ask you an honest question. What do you really care about here? Where this case is concerned, I mean. Do you really want the truth?
Fabletown.
This is about protecting Fabletown. And some asshole murders two of our people. It's my job to bring them down.
Then why are you here? You know who murdered them. Georgie. He's dead, isn't he? My point being, the killer has been dealt with. You've won.
You really think I'm that stupid?
I understand you have an obligation to bring me in. But you can brighten up a little. It's over. So, shall we get going? I'd rather not dawdle.
You're not going anywhere.
You know, I'm actually looking forward to seeing Miss White again.
All right, let's go. Hand over the gun.
I think I'd rather hold on to it, if you don't mind. What do you say?
No, fuck that. Give me that shit. You fucking serious?
I'm sure Miss White will be pleased. Such a reliable pup. I understand why she'd want to keep you around.
You're under arrest. You'll be given a trial in front of your peers. And your punishment will follow.
Asshole. Should kill you. I'm gonna kill him on the next play. Actually, maybe on the PS3 I'll kill him. My last cigarette.
I know. But we have to do something.
Are you fucking kidding me?
When is this thing happening?
Are we sure he's coming?
Yes, you'll have an opportunity to... He's back.
The crooked man.
Oh God.
Is that the whole squad?
Motherfucker.
What a dick.
Are you okay? It's been hours. We were worried you'd run into some trouble. At the crooked man's place.
It's nothing. I'm fine.
I guess you've been worse. You did well, Sheriff. I'm surprised. Not that you did well, but that, you know... I'm just glad you made it back in one piece.
It's about time you showed up. Now throw this asshole down the fucking well.
Yes, what are you waiting for?
You killed Lily!
She was my sister!
How could you?
What do you have to say for
Where
yourself?
The fuck do you get
These
off? You think you have the right
and
to just do
Faith?
This to people? You're a fucking crook!
Look what you did,
asshole.
Everyone, can I have your attention? Thank you all for coming here on such short notice. I know normally we'd schedule a formal hearing, but considering the circumstances, I thought it best if we do this as soon as possible. The Crooked Man is charged with the murder of Faith and...
As I already informed your sheriff, it was Mr. Georgie Porgy who killed those women, not me.
What? It was Georgie?
Georgie.
I don't mean to interrupt you, Miss White.
Georgie may have killed them, but you made the call.
Do I have to explain the situation to you again?
Wait a minute. So you're saying Georgie's the motherfucker who killed my sister? Well, where is he?
Yeah, you're gonna bring that shithead in too, aren't you?
Yes, Sheriff. Where is that rotten scoundrel now?
Is he still out there?
I sincerely hope not.
Georgie paid for what he did. In the end, there was a fight, and he bled out from his wounds. It's over.
So he's dead? That's what you're saying?
I can't believe it was him.
So you see, the culprit has been punished. There's no need
That doesn't change anything. We'll deal with it later, but right now, you're the one I'm concerned with.
You called the shots. Georgie made that perfectly clear.
In which case, you still have a lot to answer for. And
I was told I would be allowed to speak.
We have to read the rest of the charges.
What other charges?
If you'd wait a moment.
I'm well aware of my rights, Miss White.
Let her finish. Then you can have your say.
Got it?
If you insist.
You are charged with the murder of Faith and Lily, which Georgie carried out on your order, inciting violence against various members of the Fabletown community, including the attempted murder of Sheriff Bigby Wolfe.
Twice.
A misunderstanding.
Aiding and providing monetary support for the forced prostitution at the Pudding and Pie. Additionally, you are charged with multiple counts of fraud, extortion, racketeering, and the illegal possession and sale of magical artifacts.
And resisting arrest.
Oh, yes. Now, is there anything you would like to say?
First of all, I have nothing to do with Faith and Lily, so you can strike that one from your little record book.
Bullshit!
Like hell you did.
Stop the charade. We know you're involved.
Come on, it's obvious.
And there's all the other crap he's done.
Everyone just shut up for a minute. You wanted a chance to talk, well go ahead.
What?
We all know he's guilty. What the fuck does he need to speak for?
The Crooked Man has committed crimes against this government and, most importantly, its citizens. These charges, if proven, are enough to justify death. Upon which, your body will be committed to the witching
Where it fucking belongs!
That's right.
So let's get on
but
with it then!
We promised you a chance to defend yourself! And I won't rob you of that right.
What the
You're
fuck?
Really going
this
to let
is
him
about
talk?
Justice.
Love how Granny's
if we're
there.
Ever going to pull ourselves together and make something of this town, we have to start doing things correctly. No more snap judgments, no more secrets. We are going to treat everyone fairly, even when they don't deserve it.
Fuck that.
This is ridiculous.
You have the floor.
Thank you, Miss White. You've all met Georgie. I don't have to tell you what kind of person he was. He was a total scoundrel, lacking in any sort of moral fiber. I hired him as a favor to his family, you see. A promise kept to a dying mother.
Oh, geez.
Are you gonna get to your point or what?
Mm-hmm.
Georgie was working for me, yes. But he was not acting on my behalf when he killed those women. It was his business. And for whatever reason, I'm sure only he could understand, he murdered two of his most faithful employees. I had nothing to do with it.
This is such bullshit! Georgie seemed pretty convinced he didn't have a say in the matter.
He clearly misunderstood my intention.
Really?
I would never authorize such an act.
Any of you actually believe this bullshit?
Holly, please.
Tell them, Bigby. When you finally showed up at my door last night, wasn't I more than helpful? I answered your questions. I was willing to cooperate.
What's he talking about?
Helpful isn't the word I would use.
My comrades are another matter. And I'm sorry for the predicament they put you in. They get a bit carried away sometimes, it's true. Loyal to the end. They do it because they want to protect me, as I've protected them. You understand wanting to protect what you care about, don't you?
Yeah.
You'd do anything. You might even give up an innocent man, just to save someone.
What's he talking about?
I really hope you're going somewhere with this.
I see. You want to cut right to the point. I can appreciate that. Let me explain this to you. My employees are just that. Hired help. I see some of them are here among you. They are not my slaves. They are all free to make their own decisions, as Georgie was.
What about Lily? She wasn't free. She wasn't given a choice. Do you really think she wanted... that any of those girls wanted their lives like that?
So what the hell's Crane at all?
I'm sorry that your sister asked me for help, and I'm sorry that I decided against my judgment to give her a distasteful job.
Right, and you kept them in debt so they couldn't leave.
Yeah, that's what you did to us. How you kept us all
in
line.
You forget it was not me who put you in that position. You all act like I'm some kind of tyrant.
I mean,
when your government abandoned you, left you poor and helpless, sniveling on street corners, I was there to look out for you.
Yes, but...
wasn't I?
We didn't abandon anyone. We've been trying to help them.
Really?
What
about
Nancy
Greenleaf?
Uh-oh.
Her story is not uncommon. She left everything she had back in the homelands. Everything that matters, anyway. With nowhere else to turn, she came to me for help. And what did I do for you?
You got my tree back.
Oh, I got her tree back. And in turn, we used her magic to help poor Fables get glamours. Because I helped her, she was able to make a living, provide for herself. And what did they do?
They burned my tree to ashes.
Oh,
what?
Shit.
You burned it down?
You see?
Yeah, Snow wanted the tree destroyed, so yeah. I did it, all
yes,
right?
Yes, yeah. Because she was helping Crane and the Crooked Man. Would you rather have that continue?
What choice did I have?
It wasn't her fault.
You can lie to yourself, but you can't lie to me. You hated Crane, and you hated him for wanting to fuck you, and you being too soft to notice what he'd do to get it. It had nothing to do with the Crooked Man.
We've made some mistakes. I've made some mistakes. But believe me, I truly want what's best for this town. And that may not always be clear right away, but I want you all to know that I care deeply about all of you. And so does the sheriff.
Yeah, right.
I can't promise you perfection. No one can.
Maybe you haven't noticed, but we've been doing all this to protect you. We're trying to stop people like him.
The Crooked Man's been exploiting you, exploiting your hope for a better life. You would go to him for help, and he would take that weakness and add it to his strength. And if things didn't fall exactly his way, someone would die.
I don't know.
He took Faith and Lily from us. And while we can never get them back, we can certainly punish who's responsible.
They're right.
You're all still afraid of him. Even now. But you needn't be. His contamination of this town is over, and those girls will have their justice.
Very good.
Boy, about
very
three
good.
Off the well.
The sentiment is surely appreciated, Miss White. But it doesn't disguise the fact that these accusations are completely unfounded. The sheriff simply doesn't have a particle of evidence linking me to the...
Georgie was working for you! Bigby got a confession that...
A confession that nobody heard. Now, I'm no barrister, but I think such a statement would carry more weight if Bigby weren't the only one to whom Georgie spoke. Especially given Bigby's... history.
What are you talking about?
Snow?
Fuck you, okay? I'm sick of your shit!
You see what I mean? Bigby?
Maybe he's... I mean, this doesn't feel right, how we're doing this. I just...
Of course it's right! This man tormented all of you, for profit! Georgie
Let
killed him!
Let me just make sure I understand you. You're trying to say that I'm responsible for what Georgie did, because he was working for me at the time, yes?
I don't want to fucking call him the shots.
Of course! Where are you going with this?
Well, by that logic, Miss White should be on trial for Tweedledum's murder. Since you know Bigby works for her.
Fuck that.
That's...
He killed a man.
Now don't make him a murderer. For fuck's sake, killing someone who's trying to kill you is hardly...
They were there to retrieve Crane. You didn't need to escalate things.
Me? It was them. And who sent those two freaks anyway?
You.
Bigby and I have already discussed his behavior that night. We're handling it internally.
Now, where have I heard that before? How about the way he treated poor Tweedledee when he was in your custody? He was beaten to mashed apples while under your watch.
Under my watch?
Maybe he's right.
Did you think we'd all just let that go?
You can't be serious.
That was Bluebeard, not me.
He was a murder suspect.
Besides, Crane was still deputy mayor when that happened. Right before you decided to kidnap him.
It was for his own protection. Oh, you're right, dear. Crane was in charge. Sometimes it's hard to tell the difference.
That's enough.
So, you won't answer for your employee's behavior, but I must perish for
this
mine.
This is completely different.
I did not order those two girls dead. It simply never happened. Georgie killed Faith and Lily. End of story. They want to scapegoat me for their own tangled ends, but they refuse to answer for their own
sins. Right.
Oh, Faith's
please.
This isn't the point.
We'll deal with them after we deal with you. That's
I
not
mean, a
true.
Certain level of privilege should be afforded to...
To who?
This is how it's always been.
Yes. See, this is exactly to what I'm speaking. We lashed our ropes to this diseased world, and ever since, which one of us has been there for you? Who filled your lives with the promise of more? Who was there while they idly played in their towers, judging you, treating you as mindless children, too stupid to command your own destiny? Without me, who will pay your rent when you're on the verge of eviction? Who will
get a job.
Dare challenge their brutality when it leaks to our dear citizens? Who will protect you from the big bad wolf? Who will be the...
Bigby? Miss White?
Excuse me, dear.
I wanted to make sure I had the chance to say something.
Why don't you take a moment to catch your breath, little
What's
one?
She doing Bitch, here?
What the fuck are you talking to, bud?
I'd like to... I need to say something.
We're kind of in the middle of something.
All right, go ahead.
Bluebeard.
Of course. Go right ahead.
You probably don't remember me. I don't know why I was afraid to come
My
here.
My dear, I don't
Just shut up! You enslaved us for years. Let us hear stories about what you do. Told us we would lose everything if we stepped just one toe out of line. And we couldn't say a word about it because of these damn ribbons. But you know what? Now it's my turn to talk.
Oh, Liz not feel no more.
I found Vivian's body. Did you kill her? Did he?
Sheriff, this is highly irregular.
Be quiet.
Vivian killed herself back at the Pudding and Pie.
I'm sorry, I don't think
Nerissa! My name is Nerissa.
It's okay, my dear. It's going to be just...
He ordered them dead. This fucker. Faith and Lily...
That's a lie.
I was in the goddamn room when he did it. Faith and Lily are dead because of you. The only two people who ever gave a damn about me.
And this just confirms it.
He made Georgie do it. It was always him. Georgie would have never done anything without his say-so. Ever.
You're going to take the word of a stupid...
At least five other girls will back me up on this. We all heard you say it.
I mean, you heard this word
Did
to
you. You now?
Looks like we found our evidence.
She saw it firsthand.
He's guilty.
Good enough for me.
Me too.
So that's it, right?
Calm down the witching well.
No,
that's too fucking easy for a crook like that.
What do you mean?
He's gotta pay for what he did.
Listen to yourselves.
Yeah, I
can.
Rats throw them out in a while.
Fleeing from one sinking ship to the next.
Yeah, we're
so
all tight
So quick to latch onto whatever will keep your miserable lives afloat. This is how you want to repay all I've done for you.
What, you take two people's lives away and now you want mercy? What did you expect to happen here? You're getting what you deserve.
Well done, then.
Now, for your sentence.
We don't have to become murderers.
What are you talking about?
He's guilty. I know that, but we don't have to kill anybody. We can imprison him. Lock him up forever. Somewhere he can never hurt anyone again.
Boy, I'm about to throw him in the well.
How can Screw we be that. Sure he won't escape?
I can help. We'll use magic.
That's
I
not good
you.
Enough.
Maybe we'll have more
if he isn't stopped.
I don't care.
So we get
it's
rid of
too
him.
Dangerous.
Get him out of here.
We can send him
Everyone,
away.
Listen up! Clearly, we're having trouble agreeing on a suitable punishment, so I think
This is going nowhere.
Someone needs to make a decision.
Who?
I hope you aren't suggesting yourself.
I'll make the
Look,
call.
I'm making the call.
Why should you?
He is the only officially appointed representative here.
Right. Bigby should decide.
That makes sense to me.
I guess it does.
Okay.
Fine. Are you sure? This isn't how
it's what the people want, Miss White.
Yeah, exactly, Miss White.
Okay.
Can you just,
Mr.
like,
Wolf,
let me do something for once? God damn.
No.
Just do what you think is right.
Throw him in the fucking well. Where's the option for that?
Yes, sure.
Rip his head off, lock him up. Throw him in the well.
Everyone, I'm...
Should rip his head
not
off.
This way.
Oh, come on. You fucking jackass. Of course he does this shit. Bitch.
There you are. I hope you all remember this moment.
Motherfucker, you just try to kill him.
When you try to sleep,
shut the hell
you're
up.
Going to miss me.
Go to hell.
No, I won't.
But Fabletown will remember that. They'll definitely remember that. Rest in peace.
For Lily. And Faith.
Yes, another one of us to erase from the books.
All right, bitch. Damn, you got to say that? Jeez. The north wind blows.
Hey, Sheriff. Are you gonna come see the truck off? We're leaving for the farm in a few. Thought you might want to. I don't know.
I'll be down in a minute.
Okay, great.
This fucking line.
Oh my gosh, another ribbon? What the hell? Great, Jack. Got the whole squad.
Oh, Mr. Wolf? Flycatcher left his keys.
Guess I gotta go get it to him.
Is everything okay? You look...
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I have to take care of this. We'll talk later, okay?
Good morning, Miss White.
You're late.
Alright, Book of Fables. Yeah.
Someone's
okay,
gonna
dude.
See you, Colin.
He don't give a shit. Oh my gosh. Bro. Toad's leaving.
I'm going! Jesus!
We only have like 5 minutes.
And carry me for fuck's sake! I don't give a shit! You forgot these.
Oh, thank you. It's been pretty busy around here.
Morning, Sheriff. Nice fucking day. Shit! Just go grab that, would you? It's just a farm. You don't have to be so dramatic about it. Just why the hell did she have to send me and me boy away, huh? You promised me I'd get another chance. But Miss White said I had to go up to the damn farm anyway.
Oh, well.
Wait, Sheriff Bigby. I have something.
You know, he was up crying all night, poor kid.
Can you give this to Miss White, please? Dad says there's no time to say goodbye, so... If you could bring it to her?
Yeah, sure.
I couldn't take them all with me, and she said she liked that one the best. It's a willow beetle. Sure. That's a big one. They're cool, because when they're little, they have these pouches that squirt juice at you if you touch them.
Oh,
I'm sure she'll love it.
She said it was pretty.
We're about ready to head out.
What's it like at the farm? I've heard ogres live there, and they eat people in their sleep sometimes.
God, I hope not.
Do we have to go? I want to stay here.
Well, we don't have a choice anymore.
I'm sorry, TJ, but look on the bright side, okay? There's plenty of space to run around, and a nice river nearby so you can swim all you want.
Even in daytime?
Yeah. You don't have to worry about the Mundi seeing you. It'll be nice. Come on. It won't be so bad.
Have you been there before?
No. Some of the animals aren't comfortable around wolves. So you wouldn't know, would you?
We're all set.
Bye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, TJ.
Hey, Bigby! Where's your friend, Colin? Where's
the
fucking pig?
He must be
missing. He must have run off.
Bullshit.
Grandmaster Liberian.
Saying goodbye?
Oh, man. Oh, then she changed up.
Hi.
Hi.
There's your new face. Damn, why she still got the ribbon? Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess I am.
I might die if I
take
it off.
It's not easy to forget. I know it seems like I should be able to. It's just...
You need to let that go. How are you gonna move on if...
Bigby, I know you're trying to help. But this is just something I need to do on my own. Listen, I came here because... I have to tell you something.
What is it?
It's about what happened to Faith and Lily. I'm not sure where to start. Faith, Lily, and I, we had this plan. We're gonna find a way out. Leave the pudding and pie for good. But then Faith decided to get some leverage. She stole a picture of Crane and Lily together. The minute Faith stole that photo, we had dirt on one of the Crooked Man's allies. If he found out, I had no choice. You have to understand. You've seen how they kept us quiet in that place.
Narissa, what did you do?
I freaked out, okay? I thought if I came clean to Georgie, he'd get the Crooked Man to leave us alone. We could just forget the whole thing. Maybe try again in a few years.
You what?
So I told him everything. And I begged for mercy for all of us. I didn't want anyone to die over a picture.
So you sold them out?
No. Yes. Georgie promised he'd smooth things over with the Crooked Man. But then... Oh, God.
What's wrong?
I don't know what happened, but that night at the club, Georgie came back and told me things had changed. He had to make an example of us. We had committed treason. And while the two of us were sitting there, as he was telling me this, Faith walked in, and I had to watch while Georgie...
Wait, so Georgie told you all this? Not the Crooked Man? Back at the well, you said...
I know what I said.
But it wasn't the truth, was it?
Dang, you just
made me
kill him for no reason,
basically. I know the Crooked Man did it. So what if it wasn't the whole truth?
I guess, what's done is done.
Exactly. I know he ordered their deaths. I wasn't gonna let him get away with it because of a stupid technicality. Especially after... That night, after Faith. I tried to warn Lily, but she wasn't with her scheduled appointment. So I did the only thing I could do. I left Faith's head at your doorstep.
She didn't want to do that.
You?
I walked her over here, and I left her.
So, that piece of fabric I found near there, that was you?
Yeah. I cut my leg trying to get over the fence.
Oh, okay.
So you started all this.
I just pointed you in the right direction. People like us get forgotten all the time.
I mean, she
the crooked man was counting on
with
that.
The whole case, so.
When we that suffer, we do it in silence. And the world likes it that way. We just fade like we never existed. I couldn't watch that happen to Faith or Lily. Nobody cares about us.
I'm sorry, Nerissa. I'm sorry that's what it took to get me to pay attention.
It'll be different now. We'll make things right.
That's right.
You and Snow.
I don't know. Seems like no matter what I do, it's just not enough for her or anyone. I just can't win with these people.
I know it might feel that way, but they need you, Bigby. Both of you. You two make a good team. The way you look out for each other and look out for us. You don't see that a lot these days.
I go out there and I do my job. I put my life on the line. I get shot at. I do what has to be done for them. But at the end of the day, I'm still the bad guy.
Just like real life.
But they'll come around. You'll see. After everything you've done for us, maybe they don't want to admit it, but without you, none of this would have happened. You listened when no one else would. You protected your friends, no matter the cost. And you brought justice to this town, finally. Because you brought the Crooked Man in, everyone saw who he really was. So from where I'm standing, you did the right thing. You've been given this job for a reason. And I left Faith at your doorstep because I knew...
I've been making a lot of mistakes lately.
But you've also done a lot of good. Don't forget that.
You've changed this place. For better or worse, Fabletown wouldn't be the same without you. You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
It's like Faith saying that.
I need to tell you something.
I have to tell you something.
I feel like we've met before.
You're trying to place me. You like my ribbon? Do you like it?
Oh,
Faith
God.
Wore one too. Would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom.
They used to call me the Little Mermaid.
Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
He said he wanted to run more tests. I hope you find what you're looking for.
I'll go out there.
I'll see you around, Wolf.
Happily ever after. Alright, and then... Yeah! Platinum, full moon. Alright, what do you do to Georgie? Let them to die. Give the Crooked Man trial. And make them alive. Threw him in the well, yeah. Did you say, what did they do? Kill him straight off? Did you accept TJ's gift? Yeah, I took it. What were your last words for Nerissa? I made a lot of mistakes. I mean, obviously, yeah. Alright. So that's it. What is this? Okay, you fought him after interrogation. You offer him protection. Yeah. You helped him avoid the farm. He's staying with me. He's dead. You killed him. You left him to die. Good. Burned a tree, lift his arm off, and made a deal with him. Even though we didn't do much. You try to take the ribbon off. I almost tried to murder him. You brought her along for your trip track. You showed her Crane's photograph. You showed her to bring Crooked Man. He set this beetle. Give it to Snow. Did he even give it to Snow? You stood up for him when Snow wanted to send him for him. Yeah. Let's go. Alright. That's the Wolf Among Us. Pretty good game,
not bad.
It's not that much QTEs, but a lot of like moving around the R2. That was a lot of the R2 stuff. I did not like that, but that story's not bad. Just a lot of confusion of what was going on. Eventually, now at the end, we finally know what happened. Then fucking Nerissa decided to like change everything again. Basically just screw up the whole thing. So she started from the beginning all the way to the end. So that was actually kind of cool. Other than that, it's not bad. Game is definitely recommended. Would definitely play this. Sequel's coming out. Can't wait for that sequel.
even though this came out, what, 2014? Sequel finally coming out. It was 2020, this is like almost 10 years later, holy shit.
Yeah, so yeah. That's it, it's The Wolf Among Us. So like, I guess episodes 1, 2, and 3, you have to rewind to select certain stuff. While chapter 4 and 5, you don't really have to do much, but just run through the game. But obviously chapter 4, you gotta pick the pin cushion, and then chapter 5, you gotta make sure Mary says a certain dialogue for Mary. That's kind of it. Yeah, other than that, that's The Wolf Among Us. Sit there, just run through the credits now. Not in me, alright. All the people. Mojo Jojo. Somebody actually had to name that. Continue the story. Oh, I gotta read the books.